Hello, my name is Peter and welcome to Not That Kind of a Channel. Today we're going to show you how to add a new key to our Land Rover Discovery 4. Our Land Rover Discovery 4 is from 2012, and when we bought this car we only got one key. So that's the problem, and now I want to add a new one. So I decided to buy a new one on eBay for about, I think it was 15 or 20 bucks. And yeah, to add the key, I will use a very famous aftermarket tool. It's from GAP Diagnostics. It's the IID tool. It will be connected with Bluetooth over your iPhone or your Android app. And yes, this is how it looks like. The reason why I bought this IID tool is if you go to your Land Rover dealer and let them delete a fault or an error from your system, they will charge you 70 euros for only deleting an error message. And if you have other faults, like some fault in your air suspension or anything else, it will cost you a lot of more money. And if you want to add this key to your car, they will charge you 400 euros. So the price for this thing is 550 euros, so it's a very good value for this price, I think. Because with this you can do everything on the car. You can read your engine data, you can read everything. They show you everything from the car you want to know. So I think this is one of the best aftermarket tools you can buy. There will be a lot of more. I tested one, I think it was from iCarSoft, cost about 150 euros. But with that tool, you only can read your faults, delete your faults, or add a new battery and do the service reset or something like that. But with that, as yes, you can do a lot of more. And I have to say, this is not a commercial. I bought this on my own, so yes. Okay. And after that, I think we take the key and look inside the car. So, we're now on the driver's side. Let's unlock the car and let's look where we put this IID tool in. I hope you can see it. So, just wait a minute, I'll take the camera and show it to you. So, let's go in there. It's under the steering wheel. I hope you can see it. It's a little bit dark in here. So just wait a moment. I will light it up with my smartphone lamp. So you can see it here. It's under here. And then you'll only take it and you'll plug it in. Yes, and that's it. So, and now let's change into the car. We're now here in the car and I've got the new key, this eBay. And the original one. I think you need the original one to add the new one. Yes. And now we need to turn on the ignition. I think it would be better if we start the car, but I think the voltage of the battery is high enough. So let's open the app. I hope you guys can see it. It's the GAP IID control app. It's available on the iOS store or on the Android Google Play store. So for next, we're going to search for the tool. Hope you'll find it. Yes. Loaded. So, okay. Tool information has been updated. Great. So what's next? Okay. The next thing is we need to do, I think it was the service test and the BCM body control. Yes. And here you can see it. And here's add a new key. So let's try it. I've never done this before, so I hope it will work. routine, we'll add a new key, no change will be made to actual keys. Okay, continue. What I forgot to say, as I saw it here, you can check how many keys you currently have. So I only have one, but let's see. Routine, we'll add a new key, you proceed. Okay, yes. So executing routine, let's see what's coming out. Yes. Okay. As we can see, there are two keys programmed for this car, but only one valid key is detected. As I said, I think the pre-owner lost the key, or I don't know, or it was damaged. but I only have one key, so okay. So let's try it and add a new one. Let's hope it will work. Okay, continue. One functional key is required. Okay, yes, we have one functional key, the original one. So let's continue. Ensure ignition is on. Yes, it is on. Proceed with this routine. Yes. So, executing routine. I don't really know what it is doing at that. Routine started. Wait, completion. Okay. Executing routine. One functional key is required. Yes. Ensure ignition is on. Proceed to routine. Yes. Executing routine. Maybe we should start the car. I don't know. Waiting started to complete. Operation failed, E5, why? So, in the meantime, I did a little research about the problem. And the problem is that some cars have different ECUs. And they will cause a problem, so you have to send your ECU infos to GAP Diagnostic, and yes, and they will send you back, hopefully back, how you'll do this. So I found this very short 40-second video from them on how to do it, and I'll show you at the moment, but I only need the email address at Diagnostic. Okay, so I switch back, and yes. You need, in the main menu from the IID tool, you need to go to ECU info. I did this already, but I'll show you. I refreshed that, so all ECUs will be scanned. As you can hear, I started up the car because it's very cold today. Yes, and so the seat heating is really comfy. So, hopefully he's doing this well. Yep. Okay, now you only share this with GAP team at gap-diagnostic.com. So I will write them a small, short text. What's the problem? Hello, guys. Hello, guys. Oops, it was too much. Oops, I tried to add a new key. New key. But I got an E. I think it was an E5. Made some screenshots from that, so let's have a look. Yes, okay. This version of Kima, okay. So what was the other one? Operation failed E5. Okay, so let's add this. I tried to add a new key, but I got an E5. Well, error when I executed the operation. Can you guys help me? Thanks. So worth it. And all the best, Peter. So send it. I hope they will respond soon, and then I can continue with the video. So hello and welcome back again. What happened in the meantime? In the meantime, I get an email from the GAP guys, how to do and how to flash or update my IID tool. And so I did. It's very easy. You just have to connect your IID tool to your computer and start the update the tool, and then install the update by clicking one button, and that's it. And after that, you have to go to your car, plug the IID tool in, flash the specified ECU, and update the ECU info again and send them back to the GAP guys. I hope this time it really works. So let's see. Okay, let's go to the car. So guys, I am back in the car right now, and the instructions from the GAP team was, we are ready for key programming, up to the tool again, to special build, blah blah blah. Okay, so in the vehicle, prepare all keys. Okay, we got all keys here. Menu ECU flash KVM at key. Okay, so I would say let's try it. Okay, we need to turn the ignition on, go into the GAP tool, search the tool. Hope you guys can see it. It's loading pretty quickly. So what did they say? What was the next step? The next step was prepare keys, menu ECU flash. Okay, so let's flash it again. ECU flash. That's strange. It's not in here. Let's try this. Flashing duration from about 20 seconds. Continue. Yes. Okay, ignition will return on automatically. Okay. So let's see what happens. I guess it will be dark in here as the last time. So okay, actually we have light. Switching ignition on. Oh, now it's dark, so let's wait. What will happen? Flashing in progress. Okay, back on again. Switching ignition off. Flash completed. Routine will add a new key. No change will be made to actual keys. No, cool. Okay, continue. One functional key is required. Yes, we have one functional key. Proceed with this routine. Yes. Executing routine. So, now it gets... When prompt, press and hold unlock key, okay, on the new key. So this is the new key. Let's try and see what happens. Continue. Press and hold now, okay. Okay. Okay, let's see what happens. Press and hold now. Maybe I should change my fingers. Okay, so what's going on? Executing routine. Operation succeed. Well, that's great. So, continue. Now let's see if what happens. Switching ignition on, okay. That's funny. Okay, ECU initialization. 5 seconds remaining, so good. The original key is over here, clearing faults. And this should be the new one, so let's see what happens. Okay, we have to wait again. 15 seconds. I'm a little bit excited what happens now. It's cold out here. So, switching ignition on. Yes. Back on again. Clearing faults. Next time engine is started, start it. Stop it. And then restart it. Okay, let's do this. Continue. Upload succeeded. Flash completed. So, we will start it. Then we'll shut it down. Wait a few seconds. And then we'll start it again. So, now let's see what happened. I will turn the engine off and then try to lock our car off. And whoa, boom, it really works. Turn it on. This is the new key. Great. So I think we're done for today. I'm very happy to have a new key. And I really would like to say thanks to the guys of the GAP team. They responded really, really quickly and were really, really helpful, especially with my problem here. So thanks again. And for the next time, I think I will make a video about calibrating the suspension, the air suspension, because in our Land Rover we have a problem on the left back side. The suspension in the back of the car on this side is, I think, 2 centimeter or 1 centimeter lower than the other corners. And so I will try to calibrate this with the IID tool. It should also be possible. You can calibrate it with this tool. Yes, and for the future I will make some other videos. How about to change, how to change the oil of the car, how do the service and everything else. So if you like it, please leave a thumbs up here, and if you want to see more, or if you want to see how to do other things on this car, maybe you like to follow. So I will link the tool in the description. As I said before, it's not a cheap one, but I think it's really helpful, and it costs less than driving to a Land Rover dealer and clearing faults and the other stuff I said before. So I would like to say thanks for watching and hope to see you again, and see you soon. Bye.